continue watching to find out more. This clip will be aired with more subtitles later today. On Saturday, August 17, 2024, our most treasured Supreme Master Qinghai, vegan, took time from her intensive meditation retreat for the benefit of the planet to speak about how recently hearing a poem that she had written decades ago had deeply touched her and reminded Master of the beautiful, dreamlike life that she wants us all to have in this world.
Hello, all my dear friends. May God bless you, love you, and show you His love. May you also know His love and blessing. Today, while I was preparing a little meal for myself, I coincidentally listened to one of the earlier poems. It must have been written some decades ago. And I was so kind of surprised, mesmerized, listening to it. It was in Aulasis. And when I read the translation, I thought, oh, there's some words missing, not translated correctly, detailedly. I think I have to revise, check out the translation and add in some more words to make it more complete and perfect. Never mind, it's not the main point. The main point was that I was so homesick listening to that. I can't remember the whole poem now, so quickly in my head. Many poems I wrote spontaneously, naturally, and I did not always have time to check and to correct or to make some additions. And I have to thank you, the team, the one that thought of that poem and put it on our schedule to air.
Không thể sống được đâu, cuộc đời giam hãm quá. Tôi muốn đi thật xa về vực miền hoang lạ, vượt lên khỏi gông cùm đến địa đàng thơm hương, nơi gió trời dịu dàng, mến mong lòng bình an, đời như là mộng đẹp, giá vào ta thanh thang. Nếu người không bình lặng, đừng gợi hãy chiều em, để tôi cùng cánh chim, cùng mặt trời vươn dậy. Tôi sẽ nằm mơ trên cung trăng và làm thơ bên cạnh hoa lan dài, cá vui trong làn mưa mát rượi vào hè, trèo cây rừng và đùa sóng trùng dương ngày xuân sớm mơ. Tổ tranh trên cỏ mời tôi sẽ tung tăng cùng bướm vàng, ẩn nấp với cá sông, hát những câu đồng dao tàn đêm thu mát, dạo con đường mòn tân yêu mời mọc, nhặt trái hồng vừa rụng xuống ân cần. Sống cuộc đời đơn kết những hân hoan, quên sau lưng bao thị phi oan trai, tôi chỉ muốn được là tôi, được thở hít khí trời. Thiên thần xin hãy giúp Thượng Đế xin cứu người.
This and many more poems by Supreme Master Ching Hai, vegan, are free for download at suprememastertv.com/poems and smchbooks.com.
Oh, it was really refreshing my mind so much, refreshing my heart and make me a little nostalgic. Because the poem was beautiful, not because I made it, but because it is beautiful. It probably speaks to many of the viewers, especially those God disciples who are under my care. Sometimes I forget, or I don't know how to express it. They say my disciples, but they're all God's disciples. I'm just a humble instrument to communicate what God has already bestowed upon them inside their hearts. Now, I was taken away by the poem, even though I wrote it myself. But it's been so many decades already. Time passed so quickly. Only now I realize that my time is so precious because there are so many things I can do and have done and can do still and will do with my time. It's just that I feel like my time is so short. The poem was really so awakening to me, even though I wrote it and I know some of it. Still remember some of it now that I have listened to it. Before that, I also knew about it, but I didn't have time to think about my past. Only the present and the future of the world. It takes too much, all of my attention, all of my time, all of my energy. I have to always keep renewing myself, renewing my energy in order to keep up with the work that is assigned to me by God Almighty and all the Buddhas, saints, and sages in all directions and all times. The poem has some expressions that really still strike me, you know, and it awakens my heart. And see, it makes my emotion, my dream, come alive again. Yes. Something like, I would like to be me, myself only, and do the things I really like to. Even if other people think they are crazy and foolish, I will like it. And I will have my dream on the surface of the moon. I will rise with the sun in the morning. I will write my poetry on the leaves of the wild orchids and paint on the blades of grass. Imagine how free, how carefree can that be, that you write your poem and do not think or care whether or not it will be printed or it will remain on the orchid's leaf. Imagine how weak the orchid's leaf can be, very little, very small, very fragile. But you would write a poem on it and so offer it to the universe, to God Almighty, to all who can connect with you or not. It doesn't matter if they enjoy it or not. You just wrote it because you wanted to. And paint on a blade of grass, imagine how long can that last. But this was my dream. I mean, a poetic kind of expression, the dream of a carefree life, of a life without any plan, any organized thoughts or any concrete arrangement for the future or for anyone to see or for anything at all. You just do it because you want to do it. This is something good. It's awakening me again, and it brought me to tears. Because that's the life I want to have for this world. And I'm still working on it. I'm still fighting for it. You have seen many predictions about our present years on Earth, like about 2022, 2023 even, especially now, stronger still, stronger. 2024 up to 2027. we have too much upheaval, too much disaster, too much sorrow, disease, and all kinds of new disasters and diseases come up. Our old ones revisit. Those deadly, terrifying kinds of pandemic diseases that we thought we had put behind us or overcome.
Disease X could be on its way. British healthcare professionals are gearing up for Disease X, which they say may be deadlier than COVID-19 and may have a similar impact as the Spanish flu. The WHO says Disease X could be a new agent, a virus or a bacterium or fungus without any known treatments. An expert, Kate Bingham, who has issued a warning, mentioned that the virus has the potential to result in 20 times more fatalities than COVID-19.
The upper estimate is 100 million deaths in 1918. This time it may be 400 million people died. That is a really horrendous number.
Would you believe me if I told you that the assassination attempt on President Trump's life was actually prophesied in great detail months ago? Back in March, this guy named Brandon Biggs actually prophesied in some detail the events that just transpired.
And I saw Trump rising up, and then I saw an attempt on his life. This bullet flew by his ear, and it came so close to his head that it busted his eardrum.
I have a hard word to give today, and I ask you to be patient with me here.
Help me, Holy Spirit, through a few minutes.
The Lord took me, and I saw a complete shutdown of society beyond anything you can comprehend, even worse than 2020. He said, this, what is about to happen, has not happened for hundreds and hundreds of years. It would be a type and shadow of the Black Death in the 1300s. There was no anti-thing for your arm. Nothing. There was nothing to stop it. Anybody who contracted this thing was gone. Then I saw 350 million again, worldwide. Then I saw 30 over the United States.
I guess I'm emotional now. I can't express myself very well. Please forgive me. That dream, I want to have it for myself and for you. I will make it. I want to make it come true. Please, fight with me. Fight with me. You don't have to have weapons. You don't have to go kill anybody to win. Win yourself. Have a victory over yourself. Just put down anything to do with killing. Renounce killing so that you won't get killed in the same way. That's it. Very simple. Repent to God. Vow to yourself that you will U-turn so that one day we will go back to heaven. Together, or one after another, I'll be waiting for you to welcome you at my heavenly abode that God has permitted me to create for you. My home is not here on earth, but my home is in heaven, where it never can be destroyed. You will never be eliminated, harassed, molested, or oppressed in any kind, in any way at all. You will live as you, yourself, as in the dream that I have written about in that poem when I was of younger age. I don't feel old. I tell you honestly, I don't feel old. It's just my body sometimes complains because I overuse it. I work day and night sometimes. I don't care about eating, sleeping, unless I truly can't wear no more and drop dead somewhere on the floor or on the sofa. It doesn't matter. I work because I know if you're happy, I will be happy. If you're in pain, I'll be in pain. I work for myself, but in your name, in the name of God. But truly, it's for myself because it's unbearable, all the pain I witness every day, even just from the news, from the screen of the television or my little phone. It is still real to me, and the pain is raw and will never stop until this world becomes a paradise. I mean, less than the real paradise, perhaps, but why not? I ask God why, if they want to stay here, why not? If they want to stay in their dream, in the dream state, you know, in the illusion, why not? Let them be. But at least it has to be nice and comfortable, just like a heavenly world. I want to make this world a heaven for you. Those who don't want to go to the real heaven still can enjoy a heavenly life, peaceful life, wonderful life, just like the way I dream in my poem. When I was so desperate, I remember the poem is called Screaming Out Loud. And it was in desperation for this world, seeing this world in such a sorrowful state that I wrote that poem. And I want to make that dream come true. Thus, I've been fighting all these decades with you and without you. I just hope one day, very, very soon, you will help me. Fight with me on my side, by my side, so that you will have that dream come true, a heaven on earth, where you could still have everything, but wholesome things, healthy things, saintly things, because you be saintly beings who live on this planet as if in heaven. I have sacrificed everything. All my physical magic, for example, like you could fly in the air, traveling by air, not airplane, but yourself in the air, and escape from danger by being invisible. Disintegrate your body in times of trouble and reassemble it again somewhere else so that you can escape temporarily. You know, you can walk through walls, through doors, open any locked door of the prison or anything at all when you want to be free. These can make a more convenient life for me, a more comfortable life. But I had to sacrifice all that because I interfere with the world and you're not allowed to use any magical power openly. But sometimes I had to use it to some little thing to cure my dog person, but still I had to pay dearly. And it's, even if you want to pay for everything, you can't do it. You're not allowed to. Otherwise, you will be stripped of your title, thrown away from the mission, and God probably will never want to use you again or let you be in existence again. Not to talk about being a master. In the initiation time, we have told you how to know which level you are in the five levels, what kind of landscape, scenery that you will see inside your vision.
And further upward, the new realm.
Not the outside things. No, no, nobody can see what you see. And what kind of melody, music, or teaching from God you will hear at what time or stage of your spiritual development. You know all that. So do not try to claim yourself as whatever Guruji or Great Master or even Buddha already. How can you be? You know. You know that you don't have anything at all. You don't know anything about the inner world. And you're such a low level.
I know some of you might want to help others. So exactly for that, we must do the right thing. If someone is hungry and thirsty, you can't just give them dirt. You must give them proper food and liquid to drink, and medicine if you can. If you cannot give what's needed and might even harm by your ignorance, then it is a disaster for both.
Because if you're a little higher level, even lower level, you would never claim yourself to be anything, because you're still nowhere. Even if you see the master come visit you in your home, you know, the manifestation, the light body of the master comes, you're still nowhere yet. You're not even halfway through. Not to talk about if you go above the fifth level, or even at the fifth level, in order to master the power of saving others, and you still have to suffer, even then, because no matter how much power you acquire from your initiating master, you still don't have enough. Not for this world, no, no. That's why many masters initiate very small numbers of disciples. Many of them don't want to. Because if you want to practice well for yourself,
you do not try to interfere with others' karma, as then both will sink like a small boat that can't be overloaded.
Because God gives the master all the power, but the master can share only, you know, some with each individual disciple.
When I heard that some initiates claim that they are Maitreya Buddha, I said to God, "Oh, please, can you give it to any of them?" I was, you know, at that point, a little exhausted from karma, from all sides. God laughed and told me, "No, he will die immediately.
He can't give you all the power. Number one, you will be dead. You can't bear it. Number two, the master has to share with many disciples and save some for himself." And I told you at the moment, nobody, not one of my disciples or other people's disciples has reached that stage of complete enlightenment so that he can fulfill all the power from God, and God will give him power to go out and initiate other people independently. No. So please don't make a clown of yourself. Oh God, it's too cheap theater. It's a very degraded copy. And you yourself know it very well, because you know nothing. You're too low. Otherwise, you wouldn't claim like that.
Because you would know that to falsify God's gift is a heinous sin, resulting in relentless hell punishment.
You're just talking with your ego, and the demons are cheating you, puffing you up so that you will be their instrument. And when you finish in this world, or when they don't want you, they will drag you down. Look at other so-called masters in front of you. Like, for example, the living Buddha boy and rumor, whatever. Yeah, it's ruin, not rumor. So cheap, so ridiculous. Even I myself can't bear it. It is so sickening.
This trang tam or rumor deliberately misinterpreted my old poem to claim successorship. And that guy, I don't want to reveal his name yet, added some new words, altered the sutra to claim Maitreya status, then call himself a great master. He stole my teaching and gave half-baked initiation to trusting vulnerable people who don't have real blessing and visions as they should do from initiation.
How dare they do such and claim such in the eyes of all the Buddhas in all the transparent universes? There must be demons themselves to be the anti-heavens, hell-dwellers. When I reread the Kuan Yin Sutra or Avatamsaka Sutra, there was no such thing in there.
The Nepal police has arrested Ram Bahadur, the self-claimed spiritual leader, who's also known as Buddha Boy. Now, the God-man is facing allegations of abductions and rape of his followers. The authorities said that they arrested the 33-year-old man from a house in the outskirts of the capital city of Kathmandu, and they also confiscated banknotes amounting to over $227,000. Now, officials also found foreign currencies amounting to $23,000.
Kính bạch sư phụ và kính gửi đội ngũ truyền hình Vô Thượng Sư, đệ tử được sư phụ truyền tâm ấn đến nay đã tròn 32 năm. Hôm nay đệ tử xin làm nhân chứng cho những lời sư phụ nói về ác quỷ Trần Tâm. Câu chuyện này con đã giữ kín mấy chục năm nay, vì chính hắn đã nói thanh danh của người sứ giả nằm trong tay nhà ngươi. Vào năm 1996, lúc hắn về Âu Lạc Việt Nam giả làm sứ giả Quan Âm, con có tham gia vào nhóm làm việc giáo lý. Lúc đó con mới tròn 20 tuổi. Vào lúc nửa đêm, hắn gọi con vào phòng riêng và xâm hại tình dục đồng giới với con. Lúc đó con thật khủng hoảng tinh thần, vì con nghĩ một sứ giả của sư phụ phải là một thánh nhân cao quý, sao lại làm chuyện trần tục ghê gớm như vậy. Nhưng vì lòng tin tuyệt đối nơi sư phụ nên con xem như không có gì xảy ra và tiếp tục làm công việc giáo lý cho sư phụ. Và sau đó rất nhiều lần hắn lại làm điều đó với con và dặn dò con không được nói ra. Về việc hắn nói là sư phụ truyền kế vị cho hắn, đó là hắn lấy câu trong bài di chúc của sư phụ, trong đó có tên của hắn, rời cõi trần tâm.
Chú thích từ sư phụ, đó chỉ là một bài thơ trong bao nhiêu bài thơ của sư phụ, không ăn nhầm gì đến hắn. Trần tâm ở đây hay bất cứ ở đâu, không viết hoa, viết chữ nhỏ thường, không phải là tên. Chỉ có nghĩa là cõi thế gian, cõi hồng trần, thế giới này. Là tên thì phải viết hoa chữ trờ, chữ tờ. Sư phụ chưa bao giờ gửi Trần Tâm về Âu Lạc Việt Nam để làm sứ giả Quán Âm. Người có vợ con không bao giờ được địa vị này, chỉ người xuất gia mới có thể là vậy. Hắn là tên giả mạo. Hắn mạo xưng như thế là chuyện làm phi pháp. Hắn không bao giờ hỏi sư phụ về việc này, không ai nói gì cả về tên này với những vụ hỗn độn liên quan đến việc này.
My Will, poem written by Supreme Master Ching Hai Vigen in 1979 in Germany, originally in English, translated by the editors from the poetry collection The Lost Memories, printed by Jia Huang Printing Company in Taiwan or Formosa. M said this poem was written when she was still in the world, engaged in Germany. Long before she left home to search for enlightenment, no one knew this poem before she became known as Supreme Master Ching Hai, not related at all with her work before and after that, least of all to a fake for-profit like Chan Tam. He used it to manipulate innocent, vulnerable people by his evil intention.
Nếu ngày mai trần gian tôi từ giã, gia sản này xin để lại cho anh. Ngoài anh ra là quyển thuộc ấn tình, trên cõi thế chẳng còn ai thân thiết. Di chúc đây vài hàng tôi xin viết, tay run run, tay run
lòng cùng thấy mềm say. Nắn nót tên ai từng nét vơi đầy, người thừa kế gia tài tôi hiện hữu, dấu tay in hẳn con tim bận bịu, tình ngầm ngùi theo dấu mực loáng qua. Gia sản đây anh hãy nhận làm quà, dăm mảnh áo một tủ tiền trống rỗng, sách với thơ chưa bao giờ ấn tống, không kim cương không vàng bạc lụa là, có con chẳng những lời thơ vô giá. Người yêu ơi, xin gìn giữ vẹn hữu tròn. Bởi vì anh mà nguồn thơ rộn rã trong canh thâu, hay những giấc mộng tan, nên biết lòng tôi sẽ vui vô hạn, rơi cõi trần tâm chẳng bận luyến thương. Vì từ khi anh biệt biệt xa phương, đời đã lãng chìm dần trong cõi chết. Tôi vẫn biết là cuồng điên vô ích, là dại khờ, là vớ vẩn ngu si, nhưng lòng tôi một cõi lòng tha thiết đã theo người trên mỗi vết chân đi. Xin gìn giữ chút gia tài bé nhỏ, dù thân này còn lê lất hay không, dẫu phù sinh con ngược xuôi lần nữa, thì đời tôi sống thác có ai mang.
This and many more poems by Supreme Master Ching Hai, vegan, are free for download at suprememastertv.com/poems and smchbooks.com.
Rồi Tết năm đó, hắn tổ chức khoảng hơn 20 xe gắn máy toàn thanh niên nam nữ cùng với hắn khởi hành từ Long Khánh về miền Tây chơi. Khi đến Long An thì có hai bạn nữ đã đâm vào xe tải đi ngược chiều và tử vong tại chỗ. Thế nhưng hắn vẫn dửng dưng lạnh lùng đi chơi tiếp tục. Nay con xin tuyên thệ đây đều là sự thật. Sư phụ dạy không nên nói xấu người khác, nhưng nay sư phụ nói người thế gian phải biết, nên con xin làm nhân chứng để cho người thế gian rõ hơn về tên ác quỷ này. Đệ tử xin cầu nguyện sư phụ sẽ ở lại mãi mãi với địa cầu xinh đẹp này. Kính chúc đội ngũ truyền hình Vô Thượng Sư sức khỏe dồi dào và tràn đầy ân điển của Thượng Đế. Đệ tử từ Âu Lạc, Việt Nam.
When you are initiated into the Quan Yin method by an enlightened master, you have only a certain amount of power to uplift yourself, to protect yourself and some of your generations. And if you're good, of course, 9 generations will be all liberated. But that is only for you and your loved ones, your friends, and Even your pets, perhaps. It depends on how large the family and clan. But it's not enough for you to go out and proclaim yourself as a master and kind of initiate other people and liberate them. No, you must have God's permission and God's appointment. Then God will give you enough power to liberate others. You can't have too much power in this world. As a newling, just as a baby, can't take adults' food. And the physical body cannot absorb all that in one go. So everybody knows that you are fake. Don't degrade yourself. The whole universe is no. God knows. And you know. You know that you are no one, nobody. So just try to calm down, meditate for yourself, your families and your clans. That is a lot of work already. Being a master, you have to have enough power from eons, eons of time of practice and connection with God, and have to be permitted by God and other universal hierarchy. You can't just play with God's power. With universal judgment, you can't just cheat. You can't just lie to the whole universes. Hey? At the time of initiation, we talk about that already. You should keep quiet. You should not reveal what you learn to others, because the verbal instruction alone is nothing. It's the master power that lifts you up, cleanses you, and helps you to improve spiritually further. But you're not allowed to just go out and give initiation by yourself like that. Only when the master sends you, tells you. Every time, each time, not just tell you one time and then you can continue to do it your whole lifetime. It's not like that. Because you don't have enough power to help people, lift people up to higher heavens. And to protect them from all dangers on the road. You don't know where to lead them to. Because you yourself don't know the way. Only the master knows it. And when master assigns you to initiate in the name of the completely enlightened master, and you let the master know their names, then they will be officially initiated and the master will take responsibility. But without the master's permission, you can't do anything. And in no time, empty of master's grace and protection, you and your followers will be all fallen into the ensnaring clutches of Mara, the devils in hell. Myself, I shudder thinking of that horror. So for any of God's disciples, under my guidance, if you have done all the wrong things that I have mentioned before, you should stop it. Don't just jump in to learn a couple of instructions and then jump out and give people initiation. Then shamelessly boast about yourself as a master or even a great master. You must ask God for forgiveness. For being disrespectful to God Almighty and trying to delude His precious innocent children. Because your karma is too heavy. You have to keep repenting for the rest of your life, hoping God will forgive you.
Master gives protective warning to all interested in Kuan Yin spiritual practice. Because of much abuse of our generosity and leniency by ignorant people and demons hidden in human form, from this day on, the 21st of August, 2024, anyone who fakes Kuan Yin messengers or tries to teach the Kuan Yin method without official permission from Master and confirmation from Central FG must be avoided to protect yourself from being harmed in any way. This caution must be applied by all contact persons, all meditation centers, all initiates, all future initiates, and all should report to M as soon as possible if such a malign event ever happens again.
So don't try, yeah? Don't try to claim something that you're not. The whole universe sees you.
All the Buddhas know you. All the saints and sages identify you. And God Almighty knows whom has sent to be his representative and who is not. And in this time of world elimination, only one Buddha can help this world. One savior can help to save this world, to minimize disaster, or will kind of banish them. From 2024, because the other years have passed already. Still, the other years have a lot of warnings for us, a lot of disasters, pandemics, all kind of things to warn humankind, and also to eliminate the bad elements who live on this planet in the form of humans, but sometimes not, because they don't behave like how a human is supposed to do or supposed to be. Humans are the children of God, and if any of them don't behave like a child of God, then they will be eliminated. But God still sends many masters down to help you. Not like God lets you come down here and abandon you. It's not like that. It's we, the humans, who abandon God, thus being far away from the protective power, from the blessing force, and being punished to no end in this life and the next, in hell. I don't want all this to happen. I have been shedding tears all these decades because of all this. But I never stop working for you. You still have me to rely on, to lean on, if you walk my way. Because I can't help you if you walk in the other direction. I don't have the power to stop you, because you yourself are also a child of God. You yourself have the right to decide what you want to do. It's your life. We all respect that. But if you choose to destroy your peace, happiness, and wisdom, then we cannot do anything. We did a lot, the heaven workers and I. I'm one of the heaven workers under the grace of God. Many predictions about our planet from different kind, gentle, and wise people all over the world have predicted this period of our life is going to be crucial. We can make it or break it. And I do hope that you can make it with me. You can lean on me, but you have to walk with me. I used to be shy. I didn't say too much. But I feel more empowered now, so I can tell you who I am. Of course, reluctantly at first, but I have no time now to play hide and seek with you. You must come out. Walk with me. I must come out to show you where I'm walking, even though I also show you halfway where to walk. But you still did not catch it. Many of you. Oh, big numbers of you have not caught up. Please, believe me. I told you already. You don't have to follow me. You don't have to do anything. Just be repentant. Ask God for forgiveness. Return to your original self, which is benevolent, generous, kind, okay? To all beings, from humans to the plants. Wherever you can, avoid harming them. Avoid at all costs to harm them. Then you'll be fine. That's all you have to do to save yourself. I want you to live on this planet. If you want to continue that way, and why not? It's just that you cannot destroy your home while you're living in it. The way you live your life, harming living beings like animal people, big trees, and all kinds of things you do, taking drugs, alcohol, and cigarettes, living very unwholesome lives. You lower your own power that has been given to you by God. Each human has an amount of power, not to just survive, but to create, to make wonders. Many do that. Some scientists are sent from the higher heaven to help you also, but they don't do harm to others. So we should not, if we don't want to be harmed, then we should not harm anybody, anything, any animal, people, any living beings, even little insects.
the people, the humans who want to follow the Buddha, who want to be saints, or at least liberated, enlightenedly liberated from this cycle of birth and death, they have to avoid harming others in any way at all if they want to go to heaven. But that is not a high demand. Like if you practice the Kuan Yin meditation way with me, it's not a high demand to just ask you to be vegan and meditate 1/10 of your time every day. That's a tithing. It's not about money that God's talking about. The tithing is not about money, it's about your time, so that you can continue to sustain yourself in such a troublesome world, so you can balance your life and you don't fall, so that you can go back to your real home in heaven after you finish your duty or mission in this life, or even just to have a pleasure to check out this world. You have to keep the rules in order to live well here and go home after. Nowadays, we have too many things and we forget God. That is the problem. We can enjoy, but don't forget God, huh? Don't forget God who provides all this for us and has taken care of us since the day of our birth already. We forget God, so we run in all kinds of opposite directions. Anything that's against God that we follow, because it seems short-sightedly fun or different, but it's not as fun as if you know God and know the world inside while living in the world outside. You can live in two worlds, heaven and earth, and enjoy both if you know how. And it's not that difficult. For example, if you take up the Kuan Yin method, you meditate 2.5 hours a day. It doesn't have to be all in one go, maybe morning some, nap time some, evening some, and at night some before sleep. And you just denounce all the killing products, you know, or the murdered products like animal people's meat or fish people's flesh, anything to do with living beings. God has allowed and tolerated us to eat all kinds of vegetables and fruits, even though some of the fruits and vegetables do feel pain. But it's a minimum punishment, almost nothing. If we eat a vegan diet, no harm to other kicking, living, breathing beings, then you're all right. At the end of your life, you will go enjoy heavens. And maybe you don't ever want to come back to this world again. Even if this world will be made into Eden, if you know the real heaven inside is a real world, you will never want to set foot here again. That's why I ask you to thank all the masters, meaning Buddhas, Imams, Gurus, Mullahs, etc. You know, in different countries, they call the masters different names, different titles. Like before, when Lord Jesus was born, his name was Jesus, but his title was Christ. The Buddha, before he was born, the title Buddha was for him after, for those like him who had attained complete enlightenment and can help others. Not everyone who attains complete enlightenment can help others because of the affinity, like the Buddha, who has been Buddha for, oh, whenever, you can never even count it on the greatest computer machine. But he has to come back again and again into the human's world, or even some kind of heavenly world, as the Dharma wheel-turning king of heaven, and come down as a normal human in order to show affinity with other humans who are still mired in ignorance, so as to keep connected with them, with their soul. And then when his time comes, he can become Buddha, saints, or lower status than a Buddha, to help them through this affinity, you see. So it's not like you say you're Buddha and you think you're Buddha, then you are Buddha. Oh, God. There's nothing more incredulous than that, nothing more silly, nothing more stupid than that. So please stop it, yeah? Whoever you are, whether you are initiated by me or any other masters, stop this nonsense.
whoever becomes master, it is by God's appointment, by God's will, and will be announced by God and all heavens, all the universe will know it, and you will know it. They haven't reached anywhere yet. In the astral level, they just see a flickering light sometimes. Talk to some of the invisible beings in the astral world, and they thought, that's it. And that they are Buddha already, completely enlightened. And even claim to be Maitreya Buddha. Ah, yeah, this is something that I just remember now. Some days ago, someone who was formerly my disciple and detached himself out, claimed himself to be Maitreya Buddha and kind of wanted to fight with me or something. Not fiercely, but kind of, you know, angrily, yes. I read something like that. And I say, no, he's very low, that's why. Oh my God, la. Even if he's practicing anything, you know. Then his ego grows too fast to control because of admiration, perhaps, from some maybe vulnerable people. Until he got the Guanyin method. And then he got something much, much better, and then he thinks he's Maitreya Buddha. What for? If you are a Buddha, what can you do for the world? What can you do for the suffering beings, which you haven't done anything for all your life anyway? Even if you have illusion and the whole world says you are a Buddha, you yourself know so well that you are not, that you are nothing. Don't be so shameless.
不患人之不己知, 患不知人也, 论语, 学而篇。
There are predictions from Maitreya Buddha with certain traits for people to recognize, born where and when and what year, and how you recognize him and her. It's all written since hundreds of thousands of years already.
In the Akashic Records Library in heaven and on earth by real clairvoyants.
If you read all that, you will recognize who is the Maitreya Buddha. That's why they kept their predictions, so that people, later generations, like our generation, can know who is the real Maitreya Buddha.
帝曰, 弥勒降凡, 在哪里? 温曰, 听臣到来, 未来教主, 临下凡, 不落宰府, 共官员, 不在皇宫为太子, 不在僧门与道院, 降在寒门草堂内, 雁南照北, 把金散。
For as the lightning comes from the east and flashes to the west, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be.
Le temps attendu ne reviendra jamais. Il apparaîtra en Asie. Mais sera chez lui en Europe. Un de la ligue issue du grand Hermès et sur tout roi des Orients, il croîtra.
지구에 나타나는 진인으로 인해 모든 성자와 불사신 그리고 천신들이 천상의 군대를 통합할 것이다.
Эпоха Майтрея утверждает женщину.
На Востоке эта эпоха обозначена как эпоха Майтреи или великого сострадания и провозглашения Матери Мира.
Thánh đạo nghiệp duyên còn chọn đón. Vương minh ngôi vị sẵn riêng dành, suốt năm rộng dởn cùng non nước, hiện giữa trời Nam một giống lành.
Những lời tiên tri này phù hợp với cuộc đời của Ngài Thanh Hải Vô Thượng Sư Thuần Trai kính yêu nhất. Ngài sinh vào năm rồng và mới đây ngày 7 tháng 7 năm 2024, năm rồng, Ngài được tiết lộ là Đức Phật Di Lặc hay còn gọi là Chuyển Luân Thánh Vương, uy vũ tại quốc gia rồng Âu Lạc Việt Nam. Ngài bắt đầu sứ mệnh ở Đài Loan, còn được biết đến là Formosa, trước khi du hành đến phương Tây để thuyết giảng tâm linh và dạy pháp thiền quán âm. Bất cứ nơi nào Ngài đến, Ngài cũng đều mang đến cho mọi người sự khai ngộ, bình an hòa hợp và cảm thông.
Etc.
So there's no need to even discuss about that anymore. You make a fool of yourself. I'm laughing stock to other people here and beyond. Sometimes I saw some people and I thought, oh, I so respect him and her until they open their mouths and claim themselves to be this and that and others. Oh, I can only sigh in sorrow and embarrassment for them. But even then, I don't care much about being Buddha or not. It's just that you have to be what you have to be. In this world, you have a duty to do. Like Lord Jesus is Jesus. Shakyamuni Buddha is Shakyamuni Buddha. And nobody can change that.
No one can jump in and snatch their status with all the heavens watching. And even demons are watching. Okay, tell you what. I don't really care about all this of your silly noise. Just let me work. I don't care if I'm Buddha or not. Let me work to save the people and all what I can. Don't disturb me too much, then we might lose it all. If the world is gone, where would you go? Buddha or devil?
The important subject I wanted to tell you is that to practice any other method is so difficult, and takes a lot of time, not like the Kuan Yin method, The Quan Yin method is the only one that gives direct enlightenment, immediate enlightenment and direct contact with heaven, masters and Buddhas in different lands to help you, to lift you up and guide you home. I'm working with all of them, yes? Sometimes the Buddhas are also using my physical being in order to spread out more blessings to the world. So sometimes if you have good spiritual attainments, you can see Buddhas fly out from my physical being. In the inner world, inside of your wisdom center, yeah, you see that. Not because I have a lot of Buddhas. It's just because we work together and the Buddhas can use one temple for many Buddhas. Yes? But not all the Buddhas were born with such grand welcoming by so many Buddhas, saints and sages and all others. You have never read such events like that anywhere in the scriptures about other Buddhas, saints and sages' birth. So this body temple is very precious. We need it for this specific time of imminent great upheaval and great change. I want to tell you that even to practice as a normal Quan Yin practitioner, you don't go through a lot of hardship like many other methods. I will tell you soon what kind and how. You just meditate 2.5 hours a day. You don't even have to do anything. If you went out and helped with advising people about the vegan diet to make them rethink their life about killing others or the indirect killing to eat other beings, then it's your choice, your voluntary choice. I don't ask you to do anything. I might say so. I say, okay, let's go out and help people. It's from love, from feeling sorrowful for them. Because if we don't help them now, if they die, that's it, they never have a chance again. This time, this period of time, is what they call the end times. Anyone who doesn't practice righteousness will be eliminated from existence for aeons of lifetimes. If you could even be a tree or a stone, it's already very lucky. No, you're not allowed to be anything. You just become like exiled, terminated. Life is taken away from you. Until aeons later, maybe you can gain the chance again. But this is something that is so abstract, so we don't need to talk about that too much right now. It's just a different period of our earth. The law became like that, too strict, because we make a bloodbath out of our life, out of this planet, so heavens can bear no more. It's too much debt to clean, so they just want to destroy it all and make it new. So if you are lucky and you practice spiritually, you will be, you know, there when the renewal comes. Please hurry, okay? I can help you in many ways. Just be vegan, be repentant. Thank God, thank all the masters. That's all you need to do. Thank them, appreciate them. Ask them for forgiveness. Be vegan, repentant. Praise God and the masters, yeah? Ask for forgiveness, that's all. It's not difficult. I don't ask you for money or support or anything at all. So from all the many meditation or spiritual practices I learned, the Quan Yin method is the best, the most suitable for this busy time and this period of time where we don't know whether or not the world will still exist tomorrow. I'm not allowed to tell you, but you can pray, you can think positive, you can trust in God's power and many masters in heaven to help. But you have to go the right way. If you want to go south and you keep going north, and then I can't help you. The whole universe cannot help you. Okay? So you have to know where you want to go. Many disasters are supposed to be happening already. All the clairvoyants and prophets since ancient times to modern times, they all know that, and they all have given you their predictions, and it's all precise. Like the world was even supposed to end in the Maya calendar year 2012. But then I told you I prolonged it 4 or 5 more years. And then kept prolonging it until now. But if God doesn't want to accept our offering anymore, then the world will be gone. There are 2 choices right now. Like 90% of people will die, and the world will be renewed, yeah? And only some small percentage of people left behind to restart all over again. Or the second option, complete destruction. Up to now, the heavenly workers and myself, by the grace of Almighty God and all the mercy masters, help and care, that we still can continue fighting and hoping. And I have very big hope. But still, you have to come with us. You know, you have to go heaven's way. You can't just do all the bad things that you yourself even know is immoral and a bad standard. But now, talking about that, I have to clarify one thing. I have to clear the names of all the seers, the clairvoyants, and the hearers who told you all the predictions about the end of our time. Even before 2020 something already. That was before 2020. Like even 2016, 17, 18, 19, and 20. The world should have been ended already. So if any of the clairvoyants said that, or even if the Maya calendar stopped only at 2012, they are all correct. They all saw the reality.
According to scholars, the Maya believed that time, like the stars, moved in repeating patterns called calendar cycles, and that these cycles could be used to predict future events. One of these calendar cycles, the Mayan long count, lasts for 5,125 years and will end on December 21st, 2012. But why? Why did the Maya choose this date? And what did they believe would happen to our world? Perhaps a clue can be found in an astronomical phenomenon located at the center of the Milky Way galaxy, an area where there are no stars.
The Mayans knew, not only did they know where the center of the galaxy was, but they understood that it was a light year across black hole that they called the Great Rift.
The Maya believed this was the birth canal of the universe, and that all things came from the birth canal of the universe. And on December 21st, 2012, the Earth, the Sun, and this birth canal, the Dark Rift, are all in perfect alignment. And this only happens every 26,000 years.
It was probably climate. It appears that there were some fairly rapid climate change events that occurred then. My argument would be that climate change is a primary driver of the evolution of human societies.
The Mayans believed that this knowledge came to them from their gods, and their gods then existed in the stars.
According to the Maya themselves, this knowledge was not something that they came up with, but it was given to them as a gift from the gods. The gift back then was not material stuff, it was knowledge. Knowledge is the currency of the universe.
If humans don't change, that's what's going to happen. It means the war would have ended in 2012. Or maximum, if God permits, we, the heavenly beings, I myself, together, can extend it some years. I have announced that before. 4 years, I said. Modestly, but it's the truth. You know, it could be a little bit more, because I wasn't sure how much longer I could extend it. It was only 4 years that I knew for sure, so I told you. And then 4 years, and then more and more, but I don't always have time and chance to tell you, because when we met each other, you have questions, and then we have fun, and then I also forgot, and I thought, never mind, they know it already. If it's past 4 years already, and they're still alive, then they know that, you know, the world's existence has been extended for some more years. So I didn't say much. But these days, it's really crucial. From 2024 until 27, these years, we make it or we break it. So please, just have a simple life. Please, just be vegan, repentant, worship God, okay? Worship the Master also, if you can. Be vegan, repentant, worship God, thank God, okay? Add in the sons of God and any master of your belief, if you know they are good, you know, from the main religions. And as long as I'm here on the planet, I promise you I spare nothing to save this world and to save the people's physical lives as well as their souls. That's all I can tell you. I promise you. I don't dare say much. Whatever, you know, is in the heavens, the plan. You should not disclose too much when it comes to the big picture. When you disclose something small, like, oh, some president will die by assassination, some people will become president against all odds this year, next year. That is not too much. But if you disclose the big, great, heavenly plan for the whole of humankind and all other beings, such as animal beings on this planet, then you do. And your prediction might be crushed. And people will look down upon you, thinking, oh, before she predicted all right, and now she predicted all wrong. No, I want to clear their names. All the truly sincere and clairvoyant, unconditional people, they predicted everything right for our planet, especially at this time, or some years ago, before 2024, all the way up to 2012. Yes, all the way until 2012. They all did say the right thing. It could be like that. The disaster could befall humankind. Fire could come from heaven. A flood could rise, you know, even cover all the mountains like that. Because God can do everything. God can make that happen. God can make the water run up, cover all the mountains, and submerge all humankind and everything that they have been working hard for. It could happen like that. It's just thanks to heaven, thanks to all the masters, past, present, and even future, helping with their power, because they are everywhere. They're not just in physical bodies, they're also in non-physical bodies, and they help also without us seeing. We have to thank all of them, and we have to clear the name of all the clairvoyants, especially the new ones, like Baba Vanga.
Like Mr. Hamilton Parker.
They call him modern Nostradamus. He's English. He predicted the death of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and many other things that came true. Even President Trump's assassination attempt, for example.
And he also said that he knows that there is a group of people who are the heroes,
unsung heroes, who will rescue this planet and save the people. But he just doesn't know who that is.
Đầu tiên, chúng ta sẽ cùng đến với lời tiên tri của bà Baba Vanga. Nhà tiên tri mù Baba Vanga sinh ngày 31 tháng 1 năm 1911, mất ngày 11 tháng 8 năm 1996, là một nhà nghiên cứu thảo dược nổi tiếng của Bulgaria. Bà còn được biết đến là nhà tiên tri lỗi lạc nhất trong lịch sử nhân loại, với nhiều lời sấm truyền còn ứng nghiệm tới tận ngày nay. Trước đó, bà đã dự đoán chính xác rất nhiều sự kiện lớn. Điển hình có thể kể tới thảm kịch Chernobyl năm 1986, cái chết của công nương Diana năm 1997, sự tan rã của Liên bang Xô Viết năm 1991, sự kiện 11 tháng 9 ở Mỹ năm 2001 và Brexit năm 2020. Theo đánh giá, những lời tiên tri của bà Vanga đúng tới 85%. Một trong những lời dự đoán của bà Vanga về năm 2024 là thảm họa thiên nhiên sẽ gia tăng và liên tiếp xảy ra. Viễn cảnh này là hoàn toàn có cơ sở, vì trong năm 2023, trái đất của chúng ta đã chứng kiến một loạt các hiện tượng thiên nhiên bất thường, từ biến đổi khí hậu cho tới El Nino, xảy ra vào cuối năm. Nhà tiên tri mù cho rằng số lượng các cơn bão lũ, động đất, hỏa hoạn sẽ tăng nhanh chóng và gây ra nhiều thiệt hại lớn về người, tài sản trong năm tới. Thứ hai là thần đồng tiên tri Abhijah Anand, sinh năm 2006 ở Ấn Độ. Được biết đến như một thần đồng với trí thông minh hơn người, cậu được coi là một trong những nhà tiên tri nổi tiếng và trẻ tuổi nhất hiện nay. Thông qua kiến thức về chiêm tinh học, thần đồng tiên tri Ấn Độ Abhijah Anand đưa ra lời tiên đoán mới nhất về tình hình thế giới từ nay đến giữa năm 2024. Thị trường năng lượng tái tạo được dự đoán có xu hướng tích cực trong tương lai. Ngoài ra, trong những tháng cuối năm 2023, nhân loại sẽ đối mặt với nhiều thiên tai, động đất, sóng thần, lũ lụt và hiện tượng El Nino do biến đổi khí hậu. Các sự kiện nắng nóng cực độ, hạn hán và cháy rừng có thể xảy ra ở Bắc Mỹ trong mùa hè tới. Thần đồng sinh năm 2006 này từng dự đoán chính xác đại dịch COVID-19, cuộc khủng hoảng năng lượng thế giới, những thảm họa tại Nhật Bản, Ấn Độ, Úc. Cùng lúc đó, một then chốt quan trọng nữa cũng sẽ xuất hiện, quyết định con người có hứng chịu ngày tận thế hay không. Tăng Sĩ Cường là bậc thầy quốc học Trung Quốc, ông có nghiên cứu rất sâu đối với kinh dịch. Vì vậy mà rất nhiều người tin tưởng vào những lời dự đoán. Sau khi tổng hợp lại, giáo sư Tăng Sĩ Cường đã dự đoán 5 cuộc khủng hoảng lớn về sự hủy diệt của loài người. Khi quá trình này đi đến cuối cùng, con người vẫn chưa thức tỉnh, thế giới này sẽ bị hủy diệt. Điều khiến mọi người phải sợ hãi là 5 cuộc khủng hoảng mà ông đang đề cập đang đến rất gần với chúng ta. Cuộc khủng hoảng đầu tiên mà giáo sư đề cập là cuộc khủng hoảng thiếu nước. Mặc dù 70% diện tích thế giới là đại dương và có nhiều sông lớn, sông băng, núi phủ tuyết trên lục địa, nhưng nếu cuộc khủng hoảng thiếu nước thực sự xảy ra thì nguy hiểm sẽ vô cùng lớn mà không ai lường trước được. Với sự nóng lên toàn cầu, các dãy núi tuyết đang tan chảy nhanh chóng. Điều này sẽ làm cho nguồn nước trên đất liền tiếp tục chảy vào biển. Đồng thời, khắp nơi trên thế giới đều đang gặp phải tình trạng hạn hán nghiêm trọng. Hiện trạng ngày nay cho thấy tài nguyên nước quả thực đang trở nên căng thẳng và các quốc gia cũng đang quan tâm đến vấn đề này. Sau khủng hoảng thiếu nước là thiếu đất. Hiện nay có rất nhiều vùng đất đã trở thành sa mạc, đất bị phèn, gây ra sự suy giảm đất canh tác với sự nóng lên toàn cầu không ngừng, mực nước biển tăng lên, đất ven biển đương nhiên cũng sẽ bị xâm phạm liên tục. Người dân chỉ có thể bị ép buộc di cư vào đất liền. Điều này cũng làm gia tăng mâu thuẫn giữa con người và đất đai. Ví dụ như nhiều đảo quốc trên Thái Bình Dương đã gần như đến bờ vực tuyệt chủng. Sau khi hai cuộc khủng hoảng này xảy ra, sẽ tạo ra một cuộc khủng hoảng thứ ba, đó là cuộc khủng hoảng lương thực thiếu hụt. Một dữ liệu gây sốc là bằng chứng vào ngày 4 tháng 5 năm 2022, các báo cáo có thẩm quyền từ các cơ quan liên quan, Tổ chức Lương thực và Nông nghiệp Liên Hợp Quốc đã cho thấy điều đó. Khoảng 193 triệu người trên thế giới sẽ phải đối mặt với nạn đói vào năm 2022. Ông dự đoán rằng nhân loại sẽ gặp phải trở ngại lớn trong năm 2024. Nếu không vượt qua, ngày tận thế sẽ mở ra. Ông từng nói rằng sau khi con người trải qua 5 cuộc khủng hoảng lớn là thiếu nước, thiếu đất, thiếu lương thực, thiếu nhân lực và thiếu đạo đức, một kỷ băng hà sẽ mở ra. Tuy nhiên, 4 cuộc khủng hoảng trên vẫn chưa phải là nguy hiểm nhất. Nguy hiểm nhất vẫn là khủng hoảng cuối cùng. Đó chính là thiếu đạo đức. Ở đây, thiếu đạo đức không phải là lời mắng người, mà là nói rằng con người thiếu chuẩn mực đạo đức, thiếu tín ngưỡng và niềm tin, trở thành những cái xác không hồn, chỉ biết thỏa mãn dục vọng và trút bỏ dục vọng. Giáo sư cho rằng năm 2023 là năm Mão, tức là một năm đói kém nghiêm trọng. Về năm 2024, giáo sư Tăng Sĩ Cường nói đó là năm rồng và con người sẽ phải đối mặt với một chặng đường quan trọng. Nếu vượt qua được chặng đường này, nền văn minh nhân loại sẽ tiếp tục kéo dài hàng chục năm. Nhưng nếu không vượt qua được chặng đường này, ngày tận thế của nhân loại có thể sẽ đến sớm hơn.
And I feel we may lose the Queen next year, at the end of next year, in 2022 or early 2023.
There's going to be an assassination attempt on Trump, I think. That will fail, but he might maybe get wounded or something like that.
Nhà tiên tri Anh. Trong khi đó, nhà tiên tri nổi tiếng người Anh Greg Hamilton Parker, người được giới truyền thông phương Tây gọi là nhà tiên tri vận hạn, ông đã đề cập một điều khá tương đồng và cũng khá kỳ lạ rằng năm 2024, thế giới sẽ hình thành hai liên minh lớn là Đông và Tây. Đồng thời, trái đất sẽ bước vào một kỷ nguyên trật tự mới được thiết lập bởi liên minh phương Đông. Họ sẽ dẫn dắt thế giới đến hòa bình và nhân vật quan trọng nhất của Liên minh Phương Đông là một chủng tộc mới. Parker không biết những con người mới này xuất hiện như thế nào, nhưng họ có sức hút không gì sánh được. Ông ấy đã cố gắng lý giải về họ, nhưng rất mơ hồ, chỉ biết rằng họ sẽ trở thành anh hùng giải cứu thế giới.
I do feel that there is and will become new people into the world who are going to have a higher level of consciousness. I feel it's more like very highly evolved spiritual beings coming into the world. And eventually the religions of the world, I feel, will join in this kind of universal religion, though it's more of an unspoken thing. It's not a doctrine. It's not following a book or a set teaching. It's about personal direct experience.
Parker còn nhìn thấy một khả năng khác, đó là mặt trời sẽ sớm bị phân hủy, khiến phương Tây chìm vào bóng tối. Nhưng điều kỳ lạ là một mặt trời mới lại xuất hiện ở phương Đông và tiếp tục thời đại phồn vinh. Có lẽ đây là công lao của những con người mới và việc họ giải cứu thế giới.
And many other masters of clairvoyance since ancient times already up to now predicted it's all correct. That the world could have been destroyed like that. Suddenly, you might not even have been warned or anything. But heavens warns you even by different disasters, by different kinds of strange weather, strange sky events, strange phenomena.
亲爱的师父和无上师电视台团队，在师父慈悲发布紧急讯息，对异常天气和天空异象保持警觉后，我注意到太阳光变得非常强烈且炙热，日照时间甚至延长了。内在圣灵提醒我，这股炙热的阳光热能就是上帝带给地球众生此时此刻的特别加持，燃烧所有黑暗。尤其这几日集中于智慧眼时，总看到同一景象，布满乌云的灰黑暗天空，巨大极亮的白色闪电，闪电外层包裹着血红色的红光，雷鸣震撼大地，和师父在紧急讯息中描述一致。请务必重视师父指示，这一切确实已经开始发生，而师父和天堂守护者们依旧支撑着世界，为世人争取更多时间。如同启示录揭开第六印时的情景，我观看揭开第六印的时候，地大震动，日头变黑像毛布，满月变红像血，天上的星辰坠落于地，如同无花果树被大风摇动，落下未熟的果子，天就挪移，好像书卷被卷起来，山岭海岛都被挪移，离开本位。圣经启示录第六章第十二到十四节，请求世人遵照师父指示与教诲，把握时间打坐，并时刻感谢全能的上帝，让世上所有众生的内在上帝之心此刻觉醒。人们总说，若有重来的机会，一定会做出正确选择，而此时正是抉择的时刻，请做出正确的选择。我们不应再让上帝师父被架上这血染的十字架上。愿师父不再流泪，我将与圣灵合一，与师父同行。您忠诚的弟子如晴，来自台湾福尔摩沙。 PS 以下资讯给无上师电视台团队参考。 网友分享的气象照片中可以看见零星红色物质，人们称呼这种景象为红色精灵。这些红色物质带有侵蚀与迷幻的能量，令人感到不舒服。新闻也已开始报道，请不要过度搜寻与这种能量接轨，只专注师父给予我们的无上圣爱。
But we just don't listen, we don't look, we're too busy with working and eating and so whatever, family and relationships and fighting and killing. We ignored all that. So it could still happen, even with all the best intentions and power from heavenly protectors and I myself personally. I'm not boasting about it. I wish I could tell you everything else so that I can really boast about it, that you could really believe more. But I can't. I don't want to. And if I tell, it could go the other way around, so I have to keep quiet. It's very dangerous already for any master, any good practitioners to live in this world. So, I don't want to make more danger for myself. I do only whatever God commands me to do. And you can't refuse God's commands because that is final. You can't say no. You can't say next time, next year, no. Whenever has commanded you, that's when you do it. I have learned through many eons of lifetimes that I have to obey God's commandments. We have to work together with all heavens as a team. Otherwise, you'll be nothing. You can't help. You cannot fulfill your duty, your assignment by God, approved by heavens also. So whoever you are, just pray well for your own protection and your family members' protection, okay? Don't just think that being a Buddha is having a glorious job. It's not like that. You work like in hell. You work like in three different dimensions, you know? Earth, heaven, and hell. And some other things also in between. And if the karma of the world is too heavy and you continue to want to help, to interfere, to help people, to save the world, then oftentimes you have to work all by yourself because heavens are not allowed to help you because you interfere too deeply into heavy karma, yes? But I always praise God to help me, praise God that God helps me, protects me, and lets me do what I can. I do all my best. And I also hope that you do your best and God will protect you. God will take you home by some means. Or through my physical interference and physical way leading the road to take you home, to your real home, then you will know, oh, this material world here is nothing. My God, why didn't I know earlier? Many people who die temporarily, even for 10 minutes or half an hour, they came back to this world. Nobody wanted to go back to this world. Nobody wanted to come back here.
My NDE happened November 1994. I was working in the forest. I was cutting down a tree, and the tree just took off and hit me on the left side of the head, and I just went flying. I felt no pain whatsoever. I just continued to exist. All I saw was my body, and then everything just turned black. But at the same time, I started getting this overwhelming feeling of joy, just pure bliss. It's just happiness. Oh. And then right after that followed love, that feeling of love, the profound love. It was just so vast. It seemed like my consciousness was expanding and expanding and expanding. And what was opening up before me was galaxies. And at one point, I was overwhelmed. There was I'll see billions upon billions upon billions. I saw what, I'll use this term, the edge of the galaxy. I did hear a voice which said, you must go back. Your time is not through. You are not done yet. There is more for you to do. You must go back. No. I didn't want to come back. No, I did not want to come back.
In 1958, on a beautiful Sunday, we went to a local beach and we were swimming, and my sister took my brother and I on a raft, and I went down deep, deep, deep into the water. And I could hardly breathe. I mean, I knew that I was drowning, and I was only 7 years old at the time, and I couldn't help myself. I couldn't do anything to help me. And all of a sudden, I saw a white light, and it was a magnificent white light, and it pulled me toward it. And I started moving up and up, and I got closer and closer. I got closer to the white beam, the white light, and there, at the very end of it, was a white being just shining, absolutely beautiful. I felt nothing but love, empathy, kindness, caring, warmth, genuine love. It was amazing, and it just filled me up. It filled up my heart. It filled up everything around me. Here was a seven-year-old, you know, feeling safe in a place that was so unfamiliar. And I wanted to stay there forever. And things were said to me. Things were told to me. And then they told me that it was time for me to go back. That it was time for me to return.
My name is Diane Sherman. I grew up in Beverly Hills, California. I had waited 10 years to have that surgery because at that time I would have had to have had a full-on open patella knee surgery. 10 years later, it's now time to have it. So I'm in recovery, but I'm hearing them saying, Diane, wake up. Diane, wake up. The next thing I'm feeling is I'm being pulled back and then pushed forward into darkness. And as I see this one little spot of light, I think, I'm going to just hang in with it and it's going to be okay and I'm going to be okay. And, you know, I just worked that inside of myself. And as I'm staring at it, it's starting to get bigger and bigger and bigger, and it's coming closer and closer. And all of a sudden, it's just, it's everything around me. And I'm looking at the light and I'm thinking, what is this? Because it was like clouds. The white is a color I've never seen before. It almost has like all the colors of the rainbow in it, but it's white. You know, it has this glistening effect to it. It wasn't just light. It was substance and feeling, and it's all around me. It's all I can see, all I can feel, all I can experience. And I don't have words for it. How do you describe unconditional love? I don't know how to describe it. All I know is I have never felt so cared about, adored, cherished, safe. Anything you'd ever wished for to have in the world in that moment is what I felt. Satisfied. Satisfied beyond my wildest dream. And as I'm feeling this, I'm now moving through it, and it's parting. And all of a sudden, I see these two rows of what look like monks to me. I could just feel the love they were radiating to me. And as I get to the end of this row of monks, this one steps out, and he says, "You cannot stay. It's not your time. You must go back." And I said, "I have finally felt what it feels like to be cherished. You cannot send me back from this. I've come home. The one place I wanted to be in my whole life was here, home. I'm here. You cannot send me back." And he said, "You have a child. You must go back." And in that moment, I'm back in my body.
Thank you. etc.
You know all of them if you read all of their books. Or you go interview them. Ask them what they feel about this world. If they're eager to come back to this world at all. They will say, no, no. You must be stupid to want to come back to this world. Only God wants to show them heavens and wants them to come back so that they can spread out His messages to awaken others, to repent early, to U-turn quick, to help their soul so that they don't need to suffer in hell or be lost in the empty universe if the earth is all destroyed and disappears into nothingness. All these souls who could never grab onto anything, could never be liberated, could never stop suffering. So please, I do hope every time I talk to you, your beliefs getting stronger in the final judgment of God and in the highest top benefit of believing in God, of returning to your original self by being good, by praising God, thanking all the masters, and above all, being vegan. Avoid all kinds of killing, even small insects, wherever you can help it. And don't eat anymore animal people, meat, fish, eggs, dairy, anything to do with the suffering animal people who have to bear all that for you helplessly. They're chained, they're caged in just for your few minutes pleasure, which is filthy food anyway. Please stop it. Please be vegan. Please repent. Please praise God. Please thank all the masters who have sacrificed for you since time immemorial so that our world has more comfortable inventions and that God still sent masters to this world to teach you right from wrong, to bring you home, to your real home. I can also bring you home if you let me, if you follow the simple requirements. I promise to take you home. I promise to God I will take you home. Once you know that home, you never want to come back here ever. I swear to you that you will not. I swear in front of God, in front of all the heavens, hell, earth beings, that I tell you the truth. Once you know a glimpse of heavens, you don't want to come back to the mundane world on this planet anymore. I swear, I tell you the truth. If I told you a lie, oh, I should immediately be swallowed up into hell and stay there forever. Now you know I'm sincere and honest with you. Buddha's land, heaven's land, is where you're supposed to be, where your true home is. Please try whatever you can to go there. Seek any masters who already know the way for you. You don't have to find me. If you don't trust me, there are some masters also in India, true masters from great lineage, from the original founder, like, for example, from Bias, India. You just go find them then, huh? They rely on their founder's power to give you initiation. But I can't promise you that you will have complete enlightenment and liberation with them. I can't promise. It depends also on you and their level as well. But I know one thing, at least they don't cheat you. They don't take money, rob you blind, or molest you. Because they are pure people, principled people. Even if their level is not high yet, you still have enough protection. At least you will not go to hell. And maybe if you come back to this life again, you will have other masters or go to another planet. And with your sincerity, pure devotion and longing to go home to God, God will help you to find another master to bring you home. Just be sincere, be humble, be repentant, be vegan. Go find a master, whoever you trust to enlighten you, so that at least you won't go to hell, even if you won't be able to pass the three destructible worlds. At least from this lifespan and the next few hundred years, you will not go to hell due to the grace of that initiation by God's mercy. Please do. You don't have to find me. Just try, but be fast, be quick. We don't have a lot of time. And you must trust in God. You must praise God. Praise all the masters. Thank God, thank all the masters. And be vegan. Repent. be vegan. Thank God. Thank all the saints. That's all you have to do. Okay? You don't have to find me as your master. It depends on affinity and your sincerity as well. That's all I can tell you. Please, with all my heart, all my sincerity, all my best wishes for you, and all my praise to God for helping you to find your way to liberation. Amen. Love you, love you, love you. Take care, take care, take care. Be repentant, be vegan. Seek enlightenment, please. Please, please, please love yourself. Do those things that are good for you. Otherwise, you will be condemned forever, for aeons of time, in hell or in oblivion. Please, it's a terrible suffering. You can't even explain in words. Believe me, go find a master. You don't have to find me. Go find a master. Praise God so you can find a good one. Please, do something. Do something. We don't have a lot of time. I don't know if heaven workers and I can continue to hold off the destruction of this planet. The heavenly workers and I myself have tried so hard all these years. But sometimes we can only make big disasters become smaller, or smaller disasters become less intensive or become zero. But if it continues this way, heaven may give up and the world may be destroyed. Even too many small, reduced disasters, if too many of them, the world still can be damaged, ruined, or destroyed. So please, be good. Be kind to all, to whoever you meet, and praise God, praise all the masters for protection, for forgiveness, and seek enlightenment. Please, please love yourself enough to go and find a master. Go and find enlightenment. If you cannot, at least be repentant, be vegan, and call me when you are in desperate need. That's all. Not so long for now. May God's love be with you. May God let you know He is love. Amen.
Most esteemed Master, your boundless love is incomparable. And we are constantly reminded of this by the countless life-saving acts you have done for all, including prolonging the planet's existence past 2012 with the assistance of heavenly workers and the grace of God. Your vision of a peaceful paradise on Earth springs our hopes that this beautiful reality could soon come to pass. We wish that humankind now truly hears your precious words and acts in accordance with our divine roots by being vegan and worshiping God. May Master enjoy the fullest comfort, security, and peace in the eternal protection of God Almighty, the Masters, and Heaven Beings. This clip will be aired with more subtitles later today. To learn why, in rare instances, a disciple of Master might not have inner experiences during initiation, what a technique for living hundreds or thousands of years involves, the enormous dangers of an individual or country slandering a living Master, and more, please tune in on Sunday, September 1st, 2024, on Between Master and Disciples, for the full broadcast of this message. Also, for your reference, please check out the previous related Between Master and Disciples messages, such as All Universes Approved and God Granted Power to a Buddha for Saving Countless Souls. Buddha, Great Master, is not just the mere title. Knowing which is the real master, monk, or priest, the false master's name the world has to know. the story of Mahakashipa, vegan. The Buddha, our Messiah, we have been waiting for, is here now. The preciousness of the human body, the three types of masters, etc. To view these and more related between master and disciples messages, all free for download, please visit suprememastertv.com and search for Higher Realm.